Earlier today, Denver became the 10th U.S. city to have a pro team in all four of the major sports. With the announcement, the Quebec Nordiques are moving to Colorado. It was a slow story developing, but tonight it was lead material on TV.
It's 5 o'clock. You're watching KMGH-TV, live from Denver. This is Colorado 7 News.
13 years after the Colorado Rockies hockey team packed its bags for New Jersey, the NHL is back in town.
The Nordiques are on their way to Denver. Comset making the official announcement today at their headquarters in Maryland. Purchase price, $75 million.
The city's last NHL team never had a shot at the Hockey League's top honor, but the Nordiques could change that.
The division that will include the Detroit Red Wings and the Quebec Nordiques will have two of the three best hockey teams in the NHL.
On talk radio, sports fans began to hear the names that may bring Denver its first major sports championship. Joe Sakic and Peter Forsberg will give Denver two of the best centers in the league, while Owen Nolan and Wendell Clark provide strength, speed, and excitement.
And I think for people, Sandy, who have maybe recently moved to Denver in the last 5 or 6 years, the thought might be the NHL is coming to Denver, and I think we ought to make it clear that the NHL is returning to Denver.
They are the Nordiques today, but the new Denver team will probably have a new nickname and a new logo next year. Denver fans have their early favorites.
I think they should name the new Denver hockey team the Bears.
Blizzard.
Would be the Colorado Miners, Denver Miners.
The Colorado Avalanche.
Now, one thing remains before the move can be labeled official. NHL owners have to approve any franchise transfer, but that's expected to be nothing more than a formality, and it will happen at league meetings June 21st. In a moment, we'll hear the guy that's behind this thing for Comset. Will join us live, Charlie Lyons from the Comset headquarters in Maryland, and we'll get down to the nitty-gritty with him, see how it all came together.
Okay.
I'm sorry, real quickly, did he mention the purchase price? I didn't catch
$75 million, which is a good deal for a team with this much talent, because if you waited for an expansion team a couple of years, it would have been much more than that.
I'll guarantee you. These guys are going to be contenders.
Oh, yeah. We'll talk about that in sports, too.
Okay.
All right. Sounds expensive. Franchise fever brings Denver a full house of pro sports teams. It'll be great for fans, but Denver will be the smallest city with all four of the major pro league sports. The question, will there be enough fan interest now to fully support football, basketball, baseball, and hockey?
You know who I'll ask? Don Cherry, coach there in 1979-80. He'll be in, of course, tomorrow evening. We'll see what he thinks of the prospects of the NHL succeeding in Colorado. The newspapers, the Rocky Mountain News and Denver Post, were at it, of course, today as well. I got a couple of clippings. We'll use our Super Zoom there. There's one of the stories, a mascot. Let's not get too cute. That was one of the big concerns. That's, of course, today's edition of the Post. Our Super Peel as well. Rules of the game was a hot topic of debate in the papers today. They wanted to discuss the dimensions of the rink and the dimensions of what it is the players wear. And I think that's a Jofa helmet. Grapes won't be too happy about that. But that was a big focus in one of the articles, what the players will look like and wear. And, of course, a lot of people are wondering about what they'll name the team. The leading candidates appear to be Bears and or Mountaineers. A rocky return, to be sure. We'll have more of our coverage of the Canucks and the Blackhawks. Deadlocked 1-1 at the Pacific Coliseum in Vancouver tonight as the tradition continues on Molson Hockey Night in Canada and the Stanley Cup playoffs on CBC.